unless they get you something somewhere major. But like in Canada, we don't have a big gun violence issue. Yeah, we have gun violence, but the gun violence is not registered gun owners. It's not the legal law-abiding citizens doing it, because in Canada, the fucking gun laws are insane, guy. You aren't allowed to carry your handgun around ever, period. The best you can do is put it in a locked box in the trunk of your car, locked separate from the ammo, and ammo has to be locked as well. And you can go to the gun club and shoot it at targets and then take it home. If you stop at fucking McDonald's on the way home and they catch you with it, you're in trouble. And it's fucking, they'll take your gun license. And that's an RPAL, that's a restricted. With rifles, you can have them in your trunk and fucking locked up and everything. You can carry that rifle around, but you can't throw it over your shoulder and walk into a fucking Walmart with it. And here's the other thing. So if you have any sort of criminal record, fucking, they ain't gonna let you have a firearm, period. And the people that do have firearms, they're all registered. You have to have your name registered in the government system, and they run your name through that system literally every day. So if you got picked up on a fucking drunk driving charge or something, fucking, you'll have the police show up at the door the next fucking day to take your guns. And they'll know exactly what you have, and fucking, like, you can't buy a bullet without fucking showing your ID and having it recorded. I used to work at Canadian Tire, and I used to sell this shit, and fucking, and the gun laws have got stricter since then, so, like, this was, I couldn't even, like, they were, all the, like, shells and everything were in a locked case, and if somebody wanted anything, I had to see their ID and their firearms license before I even opened the case, and then I'd open the case, they'd show me what they wanted, how many boxes, and I had to carry it and walk with them up to the front and give it to the cashier. And then the cashier would also check his ID. Like, it's insane, the fucking gun laws in Canada compared to the States. Like, Harley talks to me about fucking open carrying and shit, and I'm like, oh man, you can't open carry a soft air BB gun in Canada. You'll get fucking done in. They'll be like, gun! Yes. Because the true meaning of the Second Amendment was that the people should be able to have the same armament as the military, because that's what formed the states, was that the people were able to stand up to the British military. See, and there within lies the rub, and that's where it starts becoming a discussion, because what did we say about stupid people, and 50% of them are fucking dumber than that? There's gotta be some sort of, you can't give a motherfucker a nuclear warhead. You just can't. Yeah, and half the fucking state. That shit'll level fucking property for fucking as farther than you can see. Oops. Cause you know some drunk motherfucker gonna be hanging out with his buddies in the backyard trying to jump it with a motorbike and set it off, right? Like, oh shit, why is it beeping? Fuck. You know what the real problem is? I can sum this up real quick. Like, I'm fucking 43, and I remember my first construction job, and those motherfuckers damn near made me cry. They busted my balls and busted my ass. I was like fucking 14. I was like 14 working with these rednecks, and yo, they made me tough as nails. But the thing was, they respected me after a little while because I did a damn good job every fucking time. And so it like, you know, those guys that were busting your balls became your buddies, and they defended you against the fucking idiots, right? But back in the day in a job, when you had an idiot that you worked with, everybody busted their balls, right? Until they either smartened the fuck up or fucked off. And so you're not allowed to do that anymore. You can't bust balls with people to get them to fucking realize the error of their ways. You gotta tiptoe through the fucking tulips with these assholes and fucking while they're being indignant failure the whole fucking way. Yeah. There's no corrective measures anymore. So, that's exactly it. So here's the intricacy of it, right? Like, so you work with an idiot, and they're a likable idiot. They're personable, and they cry whenever you fucking tell them they've done something wrong. They work themselves into a position of power, and what they do is they start gathering the people that agree with them. Right? So, like, one idiot is dangerous. Three idiots that will back each other up are fucking... There's no arguing with them. They're lethal. Like, I used to call them wisdom warriors, battling intelligence to the death, wherever it may be found. Fucking... And... you get a group of these people in power, and now... All the intelligent ideas get frowned on because they just can't fathom the fucking intelligence behind a good idea, but they'll all back each other up on the stupid ideas. So stupid ideas become policy, and then they build a community of people that will defend each other and agree with each other's stupid policies, and they edge out the intelligent people. So the problem is that it used to be embarrassing to be stupid. Like, what was it? Fucking not even 100 years ago, like, the fucking, what's the word I'm looking for? When you can read. Literacy. The literacy rate was, like, ridiculously low. Fucking a good majority of the population didn't know how to read. And as people got more literate, and here comes the double-edged sword, fucking interpretation is a bitch. And so you educate us... A person a little bit, and they, it's called the Dunning-Kruger effect. A person that knows very little will be very assured in their knowledge, and a person that knows a lot will actually be more hesitant about what they know about a subject. And so what we are in, gentlemen, is the fucking age of reinforcing stupidity, just because they've gained mass.
And those are facts, unfortunately.
Yet stupidity in numbers. Sin. Oh, I love that. That should be a clan name. Stupidity in numbers? That would be awesome. I actually really like that, dude. Honestly, like, that's, I'm gonna suggest that as a paintball team name for my crew. Like, yes. Oh, he put it so eloquently in Men in Black. When he was talking to him about alien existence, and he's like, look, people as an individual are reasonable and you can talk to them, but people as a group or a whole are stupid, dumb, panicky animals. Yeah, this is herd mentality, right? Well, look, we can all agree it's not nice to be mean to each other. So, here's the question then. What do you do when you work with a guy or a person? We'll just say person to keep it gender neutral, because girls fuck up too. Yeah, attack helicopter. Let's use that. What do you do when you work with an attack helicopter and they fail every fucking mission, but to any advice on how to fucking actually succeed with a mission, and at the same time get indignant with you and you pulled up with HR for fucking trying to get them to do a better job so you don't have to spend so much of your day fixing their fucking bullshit?
Something about an attack helicopter.
How do you not, like, so you work with a motherfucker and they constantly fuck up, and because of their fuck ups it's costing the company money and it's costing other people time to fix their fuck ups, yet you can't correct them, because if you do correct them you're an asshole. And fuck it, it doesn't matter how polite you try to be about it. Like, hey man, you know, you can pull inside, you can have a real nice talk. Like, dude, you know, this is the 18th time you've done this in the last 2 months, and we've been trying to get you to do this way, but you won't do it. Like, it's costing money and time and fucking... But you can't do that, because as soon as you're fucking talking to someone like that, man, it's a big issue right now. Oh, you gotta let me do me and be me. Like, I've run into this problem numerous times, and I would love to hear a legitimate answer, because, man, diplomacy doesn't work. Or the person fucks up to the point where it puts the manager under the looking glass, and then the manager will do something about it, but then that's considered mean as well, right? Yeah. It's a necessary evil. Because the three people that work with Joe and agree with him don't agree with that. Right? And then you got resentment in the workplace. Fucking, why'd they fire Joe? Fuck this, I like Joe. And it's an interesting one. Yo, come on, Daddy-O, you fucking took business and shit. Mm-hmm. You gotta have something to say on this. Like, and I know you know it's an issue.
I'm really focused.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
No, Daddy.
And that's exactly it. It becomes an exercise in rules. Yeah, in Canada, all you have to prove is detriment to the company.
You got people talking. Figure there's a good reason.
I hear racing's not your thing.
Never has been. I'm into how well you can handle the car, not how fast. Jump in the passenger seat. Let me show you what I mean.
If it's... Yeah, that's an iffy one here. Because, like, even if you're not in the union, you're very protected by the labor laws. It's very, very difficult to fire someone in Canada. Like, you have to... They have to bring you up three times for something that is a detriment to the company or against policy. So here's the kicker. A lot of these little mom-and-pop shops and a lot of these companies that do very well in Alberta, because we're kind of like a have... province in Canada, you don't get a fucking employee handbook or whatever with a job description and shit when you start. They just kind of teach you your job and go, right? So they don't have themselves protected on that level, but that also means that you're not protected on that level. So they can fucking just make shit up at that point, bring you in, they'll give you three warnings in 3 days, make you sign it, and then tell you to fuck off, right? But on the other side, if they do have policy and procedure and all that shit, as long as you're within it, it's very hard to get rid of an employee. Like, very hard.
That's it! Okay, nice. Now try and hold those drifts. Steer into the corner and hit the gas for more slide.
Derailed.
Steer out and ease off the gas for less. That's what I'm talking about. Give me more. Not there yet. Keep that slide going. Nice control. Think you can do it again? Another try. Use the gas. Keep that drift going. Good. Now let's add some style. Keep your speed up and back out for as long as you can. And
because of a misinteraction with a customer.
Gotta keep your speed up. Great handling. Try again. Okay, tryout's over. How about you go around this track for real now? Remember what I told you. Slam on the gas to initiate, then steering and control is all up to you. Show me what you got.
Yeah, and as a consumer, you can bring that back and be like, yo, this doesn't do what you said it was going to do.
This has potential. Damn, Shape. Keep your eyes where you want to go.
Yeah, because I know what you mean. I had that problem with a Sunfire. We blew out the clutch within like a year and a half. It was a brand new car. And fucking, it wasn't me, it was the girl that was driving. It was her car and fucking... Anyways, she cooked the clutch in it and they put a new clutch in. And within like a day and a half of driving it, the clutch wouldn't, like you couldn't shift gears. The clutch literally wasn't releasing the whole way, right? And so we had them fix that shit. Oh, and there was a new transmission. We put a brand new transmission in it too, because we blew the universal gear in the fucking transaxle, which is like a diff for the front end on a front wheel drive car. Anyways, fucking brand new transmission, and they fuck up the clutch three times. And on the third time, we bring it in and we're like, yo, what the fuck is going on with this? Like, why can't you? What's and he's like, oh, well, the work order says Sunfire, but this is a Sunfire GT. We're like, yeah. They're like, well, we're not supposed to machine the clutch on the GT. So they've been shaving the face off the clutch and leaving it short, right? Fucking. And at the same time, we're like, okay, well, this is a brand new transmission, and we just had a whole fucking week and a half work of three attempts and clutch shit going on. If we have a transmission failure after this, are you guys going to tell us that the warranty stands, or are you going to fucking inspect the transmission and tell us that we're good, and if something isn't good, put a new transmission in because this was your fucking fault? Oh no, fucking. And like I said, it wasn't my car, and the girl's parents wouldn't listen to me. And so they literally paid full price for a brand new transmission in a year and a half old car. It was barely, we got the car in September 97, it was a 98. Fucking, like, that shit blew my mind. Mind you, that was Stu's second manual. The first one was a Firefly, which that thing was real forgiving on the clutch. But the Sunfire GT was not very forgiving at all. So, like, she used to dump that fucking gear shifter all the time and fucked it up. But, yeah, I don't know, man. So I know what you're saying about the work and the warranty. Like, it's a fine line. They're consumers protected to a certain extent, but they're like, man, they always got a fucking loophole. Yeah. I wonder how much you paid for your lawyer.
Facts.
Man, Canada's very much pay to play, man. Fucking Canada is, we don't have a justice system. We have a legal system. There's no justice. Yeah. No. Because otherwise it'd be fucking let the punishment fit the crime.
Eye for an eye.
Yo, you want to see someone stop doing something? Like, fucking, let's talk about robbery. You want to make a public spectacle? Because public spectacles are great to get the point across. Take all the people that rob other people and fucking just tie them behind the city buses and drag them till they're fucking bones. That will fucking send the message.
That's a good one. That's a good one. Yo, we put public shame like no other. Yo, mm-hmm. If you are caught stealing from our store, your picture will get blown up into a poster board and taped to the fuck of our front door. And we live in a small town.
Yep. Yep, real talk. Fucking tell your friends. You know how you top that, Daddy-O? Hmm. Free 2-6 to any information that leads to the arrest.
Free what?
Free 2-6. Oh, 2-6 is like a regular sized bottle.
Yeah.
26 ounces. 750. You guys use milliliters?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just never heard of that term. And I
yeah, well, in Canada, we got a Mickey, a 2.6, and a 40.
Mm-hmm. Yo, people here... People will also even just go for a shot alone. Anything free? Yo.
Yo, I've seen dudes in the beer fridge chugging one in the back corner, you know what I mean? Like,
any information free shot on us.
Yeah.
I am tired. And I don't want to go to bed. Like, I want to watch TV. I don't have a TV in my room.
What? Oh man.
Well, I do,
I can't fall
but
asleep
it's,
without watching TV.
It's in the Airbnb room. I have somebody here for 86 nights.
Oh shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, I had a pair of 48s. Because you saw my setup. I have two in the living room, one for me, one for Char, right? Mm-hmm. And they're on the wall. So we had two 48s, and then I got a 55 for downstairs, which is the Android 3D. It's a beautiful TV. I love it. But then Char got the free 55 for switching our cable package to Telus instead of Shaw. And I was like, well, fuck, let's put the 55s on the main floor. So we put a 148 downstairs, and we put the other 48 in the bedroom on the wall. But it's on the wall at the end of the bed, but it's mounted like nice and high, so and it pulls out and tips down. Fuck, I love it. Yeah. Yeah. Well, and the mirror on the dresser is right underneath it. It's perfect.
Yeah.
Shit.
Oh wait, that was in a song. It was in, that was in the Bloodhound Gang song. And I'll do you doggy style so we can both watch X Files. I can't believe I remember that line, but it's a gooder.
You would.
Yep. Hey, X-Files was actually a pretty good show. Oh fuck, Fringe was awesome. Yes. I loved Fringe. We watched, we got the fucking DVDs and shit. Char loved that shit. Fringe was great. Yo, I was friends with Walter on Facebook. Yeah, the not the actor. It was a profile and somebody pretended to be him, but he always talked about making milkshakes and crazy. It was a very entertaining profile. It was like George Takei's profile before he got uber political. It was like just highly entertaining. Man, I loved Lord of the Rings. I read the books when I was little. I read The Hobbit. I grew up on The Hobbit and Lord of the Rings, the animated ones. And I don't know. I think I have an inkling of where it started, but I was so excited when the movies came out, but then I had the worst theater experience of my life when I went to go see the movie. This lady... No, we... that would have made it entertaining. We got there just in time for the movie. The theater was full, so we ended up sitting in an IMAX theater right in the front row. And I'm like, alright, well, this is not terrible. I'll make the best of it. But this lady behind us brought, like, 3 fucking 6-year-old children didn't have the attention span for a movie like Lord of the Rings, nor were they interested in being there. There was 2 little boys and a little girl, and the 2 little boys kept getting up and down. And fucking every time they got up and down, they'd grab the back of the chair of my girlfriend at the time and fucking pull her hair. And it was pissing her off. So fucking she was on me. And I'm like, what am I gonna fucking do? What am I gonna do? Fight 2 kids in the theater? Like, fucking. Yeah. And the little girl did not want to be there. The whole time she was just talking, like, yeah, I don't want to be here. I want to go see grandma. And then she'd count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The whole fucking movie, lady. Until about, like, what was that movie? 3 hours long? Like, about halfway through.
I would turn around and said, you're going to pay me back for my fucking tickets.
Yo, real talk. Like, I was fucking livid and, like, I don't know. I don't like to make a public scene fucking... But I turned around and I shot her this look and I was just like, what the fuck are you doing? Get the fuck out of here. You're ruining this for fucking...
There definitely should have been an age, like, limit for...
And the 2 boys kept, like, getting up and leaving the theater and coming back and leaving the theater and coming back. I think they were going to play video games or something out in the fucking hallway. That's how interested they were in watching the movie, right?
Yo, there should be a daycare center at the movie theater. Like,
yeah. Or a ball pit like IKEA. Just chuck him in the ball pit. We'll be back.
But no, that mother should have turned around and said, I do apologize. Here, let me buy you a new ticket or something.
Yeah. No. I think somebody else eventually complained, because if I remember right, an usher came down and actually asked her to fucking leave with about, like, an hour left in the movie. And, so, like, I got to watch the end, but then it like, completely ruined it for me. Like, I've got them all on DVD, even. Fucking, we have duplicates, because when Char and I moved in together, we both had a fucking copy. But I haven't been able to bring myself to watch them again since then. My mom has been on vacation to New Zealand and brought me pictures of the movie set and shit. Fucking...
You still can't get, like, yourself to watch it, huh?
Yeah, I still can't get myself to watch it. I don't know. It just fucking kills me. But I loved the books. Like, fucking, man, the animated versions and shit were dope. Ralph Bakshi was an animation genius.
You suffer PTSD from children.
Well, for the animated ones, it was The Hobbit, The Lord of the Rings, and then Return of the King. And the Lord of the Rings one was basically the first two books. And Return of the King was actually very rare in the animated form. And it was them sitting around the same Hobbit table that the adventure started at, but they were all old and discussing it as a memory that they had been through, right? It was super cool, but the Return of the King in the animated form was a difficult one to find. You know who Ralph Bakshi is, though. You know who Ralph Bakshi is. He's the guy that did the animation for the original Spider-Man cartoon. And he also did a movie called Wizards, which was very, very psychedelic. And nice. It was about
spider senses World are tingling.
Wizards was a crazy movie, guy. It's animated in the same style as the original Lord of the Rings, where they used to put a sheet up and get actors to actually live act it, and then they'd film the shadows, like they'd backlight it and film the shadows on the sheet and then animate over it. That's why Ralph Bakshi's animation looked so real. And they also used like actual footage from like old World War II movies that were filmed on film with black and white, and they animated over top of that, and so that's how all the action looked so perfect instead of animated. But Wizards was about after the nuclear holocaust that destroyed.
Thank you.
Yo, fucking man, and there's no avoiding them. They're like a heat-seeking missile. It's like they want to fucking land on you, and then you're like, you're looking at this motherfucker, and he lands. Oh no, I'm still in here. Oh yeah, we haven't hit rock bottom yet. Fuck it. This is still a bit of a fall, yeah. I still got liquor. Don't worry, we'll get there. Yeah, well, it's early for you, it's late for me. I'm just about midnight. No, man, fucking... I know my limit, like, I don't get plastered like that, like, I maintain control of my faculties, I guess I'd say. Like, you know you got me good when you start hearing me slur, and that's usually when I start to cut myself off. But the other problem is I'm fucking Scottish. So, I don't know. I can drink quite a bit before, like, I watch my friends. They're like 3-4 fucking shots and they're like starting to be goofy and I'm like, man, that was a primer. A dazed orc. Yeah.
What are you playing?
What's that? Oh, okay. Oh, I think I actually grabbed that. Yeah, no, I got it. I downloaded it, I haven't opened it yet. Oh, Middle Earth, of course, Shadow of War. Yeah. Fuck. Yeah, man, I became... No, just when I got my hard drive, I just started downloading anything that looked interesting, and so I got so much shit on here now. I got like 3 terabytes, I got so much shit on here, I got a bunch of games I downloaded and haven't even opened.
Yo, what's up, guys?
Oh, Fluffaluffles is back? Man, did you miss a condor? I even was like, I had to stop and be like, yo, Fluff, did you catch that? Oh, yeah, flying fleshlights. That was the conversation. Oh, the mosquitoes. You had me at Singapore and flying fleshlights.
So, how would that work? Would the fleshlight be like on a drone or something? Okay.
Yo, have you seen... There was a... It was a butt plug, but it was an LED light-up butt plug, yep. And it was like... Yep. The picture to... I think it was Wish.com or something, but the picture to sell it was like some fucking Taiwanese hookers wearing these short-ass skirts and looking like a fucking car from Fast and the Furious with the underglow, right?
You know, if you guys flash? Are talking about that shit, I got something to show you.
Oh no. It's straight from his Grindr page, I guarantee it.
It's actually from my Instagram.
Oh, even better. Whew.
Yeah, so anyways, the picture is from a performer and, like, stage artist, and her name is Snatch Adams, and her fucking posts are very sexualized, the main reason why I started following her is because of that whole, butt plug thing that you guys were just talking about. And she has a picture of her doing it, not like actually like sticking it in or anything, but she's like kind of like a trapeze artist.
Oh man, tell me she swings from the trapeze by a butt plug.
No. I'm trying to find the picture. It's just taking a minute.
Because that would be some Guinness Book Records shit. You know what I mean?
Funny tits? Elaborate.
Like, oh, yeah, like a physical tit, like a...
Oh, don't worry about me. I'm just waiting for...
And she's a trapeze artist?
The one I was talking about was.
Oh, okay. That was painting a weird picture.
down to the wire.
And he just posted pictures. He joined up with this conservationist group and they went to save giraffes. And fucking, there's a picture of three of them standing in the desert, like holding their AKs up over their heads because they just chased off some poachers. And they're like, we're the saviors and shit, right? Like, they went out there and did their. Man, I'm like, this shit just gets weirder. I'm like, and they thought we were some sort of paramilitary group, and they out in the desert waving AKs around. I'm like, this is, it's the strangest conversation explaining to them that in Canada this is a game we play. They're like, wait, what? I'm like, yeah. They're like, it's just paint pellets. It's not a gun. They look like guns, but they're not guns. We get bored, and on Saturday, we go chase each other through the woods with guns, like...
Sounds about right, you know, like...
Mm-hmm. Yep. But everybody goes home at the end of the day. Bagel? Your New Zealand ass is like, this bitch speaking French, she wants a bagel, dude. I swear she said bagel. Do you guys have McDonald's breakfast bagels in the States?
Yeah.
Fuck, I love those things. They're disgusting. Yeah, like fucking bacon and eggs and fucking lettuce and tomato, and it's like a BLT bagel or something they call it, with an egg. Yeah. And when you bite in it, all the mayo squirts out the hole in the top, and then you gotta lick it like you're. It's always awkward. Oh, yes. First thing in the morning, too, because it's breakfast, right? Now you gotta wear that shit all day. Have you ever seen the meme of it's a white owl and it has one little brown spot, and he's making this like ungod awful sad face looking down at the little brown spot, and it's like, oh, that was my last clean shirt. Fucking, that is me to the T, guy. Fucking Char sent me that one day and I fucking died, and then I spilt ketchup on my shirt. Fucking like, literally, I used to leave myself an extra half an hour in my afternoon scheduling just in case I had to go buy a new shirt. I was the king of fucking getting something on me, because I'd always eat lunch in the van, right? Like, between appointments and shit. And fucking, I don't know what it was. I eventually smartened up and was like, give me 18 napkins, please. Fucking tucking that shit in my shirt. Fucking. Yet when I eat at home, I'm like fucking clean as a whistle. You know what I mean? I just can't sit in the van and eat. It's fucking inevitable. But you're right. Mayonnaise down the front of the jacket. That's always a good look. Alright, man. Yeah, I probably won't be too far behind you. Warm up the bed, your little spoon. Alright, man. Peace. Like dry?
Okay.
I fucking... Yeah, that's right. But like... I get salt stains on my hats from sweating in them. And, like, I got about 8 hats. Like, I got a brown one, a black one, a blue one, a fucking gray one, a couple gray ones, you know what I mean? I got a fox one, I got fucking... I'm a clothes whore. Like, I like to match my outfits. That was something my dad put in me. If I got brown pants, I got brown boxers, brown socks, and a brown shirt. You know, or at least something that matches. Fucking... there's a Jinx quirk for you. But... I use the vegetable scrubber from the sink to scrub the salt off the hats. Because, like, once it dries, it's actually, like, dry. So you can just fucking scrub it off. That's why I was wondering if it was... Because I was like, man, that might actually work if you use a little bit of detergent and use it as, like, a scrubbing agent. Yeah. Or not even a wet scrub, just a dry scrub with a bit of the dry detergent. And then maybe rinse it out a little. But, like, you gotta be careful with hats, because when you get them wet, they fucking wrinkle and shit like that. Like, you gotta dry them right. Hats are hard to wash. Pain in the ass. Every once in a while, I just throw them all in the sink. Yeah, I'll just throw them all in the sink, but fucking, you know, it only takes one good day of solid work where you sweat in your hat, and then you got that. It's not, it's just an outline. It's an outline of where it was wet. You know what I mean? Just a little salt line. Oh, yeah, and they start to stink. Like, if you leave it and don't clean them, they start to stink. You'll put it on and you can smell it, you know, and you're like, oh, I wore this to a customer's place, fuck. Hi, Hefe. Wait, do I have Hefe muted? El Hefe? He's the Venezuelan that plays with us. Yeah, it has the speaker, but he's got an X through it, so... He's a bit of a voyeur. He's probably just listening to us. Warlord, I think he likes your voice. Warlord, man, you're sick of being single. You like Mexicans? Have you met Hefe? Oh, yeah. You thought he was small down there.
Stupid, dude. Fuck.
Shit. Now, here's the thing. I always thought, like, I love comedy. Like, watching stand-up comedians and shit. And in case you... haven't noticed, I'm a bit of a ham. Like, I love it, but I'd either need to write something that's gonna stand up, or like, I've seen other comedians recently that get the fucking audience involved, and that's where I do my best work. Like, I feed off you guys, right? Fucking. Damn. Yeah, like, that's exactly it. He's made jokes, but he hasn't really done comedy. Yeah, Eddie Murphy, Richard Pryor, fucking Red Skelton, George Carlin. Like, I grew up in that era, and I fucking watched them all when I was, like, probably way too young to be watching them all. I was, like, brought up on that shit. And we used to get this show, Evening at the Improv, and it was a live-filmed comedy show.